Introduction to sensors and transducers. This is the first chapter. We'll cover the first chapter today. Introduction to sensor and transducers. Listen first very carefully. Okay? Then if you have any doubt, ask me. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay? Yes. Side by side, you can note your the points also. I will mail the slides, notes, everything. Okay? After completion of 4 to 5 classes, don't worry for that. Okay? But listen it very carefully first. Try to understand. Right? Okay? So now, first thing, you can see here, there are two block diagrams I have given. First one, that is the same block diagram representation of the sensors, okay? And second one, that is the block diagram representations of the actuators, right? So before going this block diagram, first you should know what is the difference between the sensors and transducers. What is the difference between sensor and transducers? Here, I have mentioned a line, mentioned a point, that is, all transducers are sensors, but all sensors are not transducers. What is the meaning of that? First, you should understand. Sensor, what is the definition of sensor? Sensor means sense some physical parameters, some physical variables, like temperature, pressure, vibration, whatever, anything. There is a physical parameter. Sensor sense the parameters, okay? But cannot convert to any electrical quantity. Okay, so that is the function of sensors. So here I have given one example, that is a boron tube. Okay, boron tube, it is a one type of pressure sensors. Its working principle, advantage, disadvantage, application, it will be discussed later one by one. Okay, just for example, I have mentioned, okay, I have given two, but it would be easier to understand the definition of sensor and transducers. Okay, so boron tube basically, how does it work? Boron tube basically sense the pressure element. Okay, that means sense the physical element, but can't convert to any electrical quantity. Means it's convert only the displacement. Okay, means pressure to displacement, converts pressure to displacement. So that's why we can say boron tube is a sensor. Boron tube is not a transducer. Okay, now what is the transducers? Transducers means transducers also sense the physical parameters, like temperature, pressure, vibration, displacement, whatever. These are known as the physical parameters. It sends the physical variables, but converts to electrical quantity, electrical energy. So that is the function of transducers, like LVDT. LVDT, what is LVDT? LVDT is a linear variable differential transformer, okay? So LVDT sends the displacement, okay? Sends the displacement is a physical parameter, okay? And converts this displacement to electrical energy, means we will be getting the output voltage. Okay, so now it is clear. Now it is clear to you. Now we can say that LVDT acts as a sensor as well as transducers. So now we can say that all transducers are sensors. That means LVDT are sensors also, but all sensors are not transducers. Means boron tube is not a transducer. Now is it clear? So that is a very important line. All transducers are sensors, but all sensors are not transducers. Now come to this block diagram. This block diagram, see the first block diagram. First one is the physical medium. Okay, medium means suppose many temperature, pressure, vibration, whatever. This is a physical medium. Sensing element, you may take boron tube, LVDT, or so many sensor transducers are there. Sensing element means sensing or transducing element. Okay, it sends the parameters, physical parameters, and converts to electrical quantity, right? So now what is the function of this signal conditioning unit? Signal conditioning means that is used for the amplification purpose. Okay, so what is the need of the amplification? Suppose your signal is very weak. Suppose whenever we're getting the electrical signals, suppose the signal becomes very weak. So to increase the strength of the signals, you have to amplify it. So this is the function of signal conditioning element, right? So next, it's followed by the signal processing element. What is the function of signal processing element? For it is used for the filtering and linearizing purpose. Okay, means signal should be filtered and linearized. Filter means suppose signal some have noise. If I having some noise, so you have to eliminate some noise. So that is the function of the signal processing elements to reduce the noise, eliminate the noise, filtering it. Okay, and processing it. So next it will come to the output signals. We will be getting the output signals, target signal handling element. Understood? So this is the function block diagram representation of sensor and transducers. Okay, next point is the actuators. What is the actuators? actuator, suppose you know, comes to our mind, actuator is some mechanical movement, okay, some mechanical device, that is an actuator, it's a high power device, okay. Actuator example, some stepper motor, sub motor, control valve, pneumatic valve, hydraulic actuator, pneumatic actuator, electronic actuator, electric actuator, so many actuators are there. So actuator always that converts to some mechanical motion, in terms of motion, displacement, vibrations, okay. So it converts the electrical energy to non-electrical energy. Right, electrical energy to non-electrical energy. Suppose we give some supply, actuator will start moving. So moving means that is a motion. That is a motion. So that means electrical to non-electrical. So we can say that this actuator is one type of inverse transducers. Right, inverse transducers. So now what? Yes.
So we can't see your screen, sir. It is coming white.
It's not coming.
No, sir. So for
sir, few of our white, sir.
No, I have already shared the video.
So for few of us,
few of us are not getting.
Yes, sir.
Now it is getting.
No, sir, yes, we can't see anything, sir.
Now come to the points. That is variable conversion element. What is the function of this variable conversion element? Variable conversion element means, suppose I am giving you examples. Suppose electric motor. What is the function of this electric motor? Electric motor converts the electrical energy to first magnetic energy, then magnetic energy to mechanical energy. So variable conversion means it transforms one variable to another variable. That is electrical energy to magnetic energy. Okay, so this is the variable conversion. And what is the energy conversion? Energy conversion means it converts magnetic energy to mechanical energy. Understood? So that is your mechanical energy, mechanical motion, in terms of motion. So now the process will start moving. Okay, so this is the now basic block diagram representation of sensors and actuators. It is clear to you?
Yes, sir.
It is clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now come to the block diagram. This is the closed loop block diagram. Yesterday, I already told the sensor and transducers plays very critical role in the any closed loop control system. This is the closed loop control system. It composed of three parameters. One is the controller, C is the controller, A is the actuator or process, and S is the sensors. So what is the function of the sensors? Sensors sense the parameters from the process, like temperature, pressure, whatever, physical parameter. Okay, so this is the process variables. Process variables means temperature, pressure, this is the process variable. But through the process, what we are controlling, temperature controlling, we are controlling temperature, we are controlling the pressure. So this is the process variables. And this is the set point. Set point means suppose we have fixed temperature 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, so now your process variable is coming, suppose 18 degree or 25 degree. So now the error means set point minus process variables. Okay, so now the what is the function of the controller? Controller is accepts the error signals. Okay, it accepts the error signals, right? Now it makes some decision. Makes the decision. How it will make the decision? Decision make is made by different control algorithm. That we through different controllers. Okay, making signals is come to the process. Now it will start again moving, and it will repeat the whole process. This is the closed loop control system consisting of sensors, actuators, and controller. Now it is clear the block diagram. Now it is clear the closed loop system.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, what is the next point is, what are the selection criteria of the sensor and transducers? Means how you select any sensor and transducers. Okay, when you go to the market, you want to buy some sensor and transducers. So what should you tell them? Okay, so what are the selection criteria? So first one is the operating range. Range means, so if each and every transducer has some maximum range to minimum range to maximum range. Suppose we are measuring some high temperature. So you have to use some thermocouple. So 0 to 15 degrees Celsius, you have to measure that range should be there. You should keep your mind and you should know the range of that particular temperature transducers. So range is very important. Okay. So now is the sensitivity. Sensitivity means sense would be very high. Sensitivity always should be very high to provide the desired output. Okay, sensitivity means change ratio of the change of output with the change in input. So that is the sensitivity. So sensitivity should be always high to provide the desired output. Next point is the frequency response. Frequency response means the frequency should be flat. Okay, should be flat means very smooth over the entire range. frequency should be flat or smooth over the entire range. That is the frequency response. Environment condition means that all the transducers and sensors should be able to work in any environment conditions, temperature, pressure, mechanical, something that in mechanical hazards, mechanical problems, okay, any temperature, vibration, humidity, for any environment and condition that should be able to work, should be able to operate. So that is the environmental conditions. Ruggedness means it should be rugged, okay, it should be rugged to be withstand at some loading effect. Okay, suppose we are putting some load, okay, it will no should not provide that too much error. So that is a rugged. Okay, next one is the reliability. Also transducers should be become very reliable, okay, should become very reliable so that minimum errors are encountered due to any temperature variation, due to any mechanical hazards. Okay, so minimum errors may be encountered. So reliability should be there. Okay, should be more become reliable transducers. Next one is the stability. Stability means that is a robustness. Suppose we are getting some output, right? Through any transducers. Okay, it's okay. Now, suppose after some time, again, we get put some input. So it should show the same result without any error. It should send the same result without any error. Okay, so that is the stability. So that is the robustness of the elements. It is clear the selection criteria of sensor and transducers? Clear all the points?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay. Next thing is the classification. What is the classification of transducers? First one is the primary and secondary. So here I have highlighted primary means boron tube and secondary means LVDT. Okay. So you can say that boron primary transducer acts as a sensors. Okay. Because boron tube is a sensors and secondary transducers acts as a sensor as well as transducers, like LVDT. So this is the one type classification. It may be classified like primary and secondary. Boron tube you may call as a primary sensor or primary transducers. LVDT you may call as a secondary transducers. Okay. Next one is analog and digital. Analog means output is a function of time, continuous function of time. Okay, that is analog. Like LVDT, thermocouple, these are one type of analog transducers. Okay. Digital means in terms of pulses. We will be getting output in terms of pulses. Okay. Discrete output. So that is a digital. The example is shaft encoder. Everything will be discussed one by one. Okay, don't worry. So this is for the example, for the classification purpose, I have given it. Okay, so digital example is shaft encoder. Next one is active and passive. This is very important. What is the difference between active and passive transducers? Active, I have highlighted, thermocouple and piezoelectric is a one type of active transducers. Active means it will operate without any external source. The transducers will operate without any external source. Means it is self-generating transducers. Okay, it is a self-generating power source. We will not give some external supply to transducers. That is active. Okay, the thermocouple, piezoelectric, one type of active transducers. Passive means when we will give some supply, we will give some energy, some input. Okay, so then it will start working. Okay, so depends on some external supply. Without external supply, it will not work. So that is the passive. Potentiometer, LVDT, strain gauge, these all are the passive transducers. It needs the external power supply. But thermocouple piezoelectric does not need any external power supply. Okay, so this is the difference between active and passive transducers. Okay, so there are 1, 2, 3 classification. Next, the last one is the transducers and inverse transducers. Okay, just now I have told that actuator. I have given an example of actuator. Actuator is one type of inverse transducers. Okay, inverse means it converts the non-electrical to non-electrical quantity. That is the inverse. Transducers means non-electrical to electrical, right? Example is sub-piezoelectric. So piezoelectric transducer acts as a transducer as well as an actuator, right? Transducer as well as the actuator. Suppose there is a piezoelectric crystal, or we give some force. Okay, we will give some force. It causes some changes in dimension towards displacement, and it will be getting output voltage. So that is non-related to electrical quantity transducers. But it will acts also actuator or inverse transducers. Like suppose we will give some voltage. Okay, we will give some voltage. So whenever we will give some voltage, it causes some dimension, charge dimension, it causes some charge, occurs some charge dimension, and the displacement occurs. Okay, so that means it converts the electrical to non-electrical. तो हम जब फोर्स दे रहे हैं, फिजिकल एलिमेंट दे रहे हैं, तो कन्वर्ट हो रहे हैं इलेक्ट्रिकल में. अभी हम इलेक्ट्रिकल वोल्टेज सप्लाई दे रहे हैं क्रिस्टल में, देन इट कैन कन्वर्ट टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट. ओके, सो दिस इज द फंक्शन ऑफ पीजोइलेक्ट्रिक. सो पीजोइलेक्ट्रिक ट्रांसड्यूसर यू मे कॉल दैट इट इज अ वन टाइप ऑफ इनवर्स ट्रांसड्यूसर एज वेल एज द एक्चुएटर. ओके, सो पीजोइलेक्ट्रिक ट्रांसड्यूसर इज वन टाइप ऑफ इनवर्स ट्रांसड्यूसर एज वेल एज द एक्चुएटर, वी कैन सी इट, और इट इज नोन एज ए ट्रांसड्यूसर्स. नाउ इट इज क्लियर टू यू द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ट्रांसड्यूसर्स? It is clear classification of transducers?
Yes,
fine. Next one is the characteristics of transducers. Characteristics. What are the characteristics of the transducers? First one is the input characteristics. Guys, now I said that range and loading effect. Okay. Range means that some maximum range of a transducer depends on the capability of transducers. Okay. Suppose thermocouple. Thermocouple measures up to 15 degrees Celsius. This is the maximum. But suppose when we visit some boiler plant, some suppose furnace. So in the furnace, there is a high temperature, 3005 degrees Celsius, 400 degrees Celsius maximum. So you can use thermocouple. No. You have to use some another temperature transducers. So that is the range. That is the input characteristics. Okay. So depends, range depends on maximum range, depends on the capability of transducer, because transducer is not capable to measure more than 15 degrees Celsius in the furnace. So there we can use the pyrometer, radiation pyrometer we can use, because their temperature range is maximum 3005 degrees Celsius in the power plant. Okay, furnace we can measure it. Okay, so there is a range is very important, minimum range, maximum range. Second one is the loading effect. Loading effect means suppose if we consider suppose ideal transducers. Ideal transducers don't have any loading effect, ideal. But we are dealing with the practical. In the practical, obviously that there should be some loading effect. Loading effect will give some load. The magnitude of the load can be expressed in terms of force, pressure, whatever. Force, pressure, vibration, whatever. That is a load. Means we are giving some load in transducers in the practical case. But ideal case, there is no loading effect. So these are input characteristics. Second one is the transfer characteristics. Transfer characteristics means there are two points. One is the transfer function and another is the sensitivity, right? Transfer function means that is the output by input, which is always that determines the input and output behavior of the system, basically. Okay. Transfer function determines the input and output of the behavior of the systems, right? So this is the transfer function. And what is the sensitivity? Sensitivity, just now I told you that sensitivity should be high. And sensitivity means that change in ratio of the change of output with a changing input. Okay, and because sensitivity is not a constant, because depends on the value of the input value, it depends on the input value. Okay, change in input value will be getting the output. So ratio of the change of output by change in input, that is a sensitivity, right? And what are the output characteristics? Last one, output characteristics is type of electrical output. Type of electrical output means voltage, current, whatever that is will be getting the output, that is the electrical output. Okay, and another one is the output impedance. If we consider some ideal transducers or ideal sensor, it has zero. I know impedance is there. But in case of practical, impedance should be low as much as possible. Okay, to avoid the loading effect, to minimize the loading effect. Okay, in the practical case. In the practical, ideal case, forget about the ideal case. Ideal case is there is no any noise, there is no any disturbance, there is no loading effect. This is the ideal. Okay, this is the ideal, right? Like, but in terms of practical, when you deal with some practical case, so practical sensor transducers, when you do it practically, so there should be always the disturbance, there should be always the noise, there should be always the loading effect. Okay, so that's why the impedance there should be low as possible, should be low as possible to minimize the loading effect. Understood? Clear? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So
can you explain the loading effect again?
Loading effect means suppose there is a transducer, there is some device, right? There is some device. Okay. If you put some extra load on the device, suppose we will give some force or make some pressures. Okay. So that means load is applied. Okay. That is a load is applied. Okay. So this is the loading effect. Okay. So to minimize the loading effect, the impedance that should be low as possible. Okay. In the practical case. To minimize the loading effect, because our aim is always to minimize the loading effect. Because loading effect means there is an error. Loading effect means what? Loading effect means that is an error. Understood? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now that ask me doubt if you have any problem. If you have any doubt, ask me. This is the first chapter, introduction to sensors and actuators. If you have any question. If you have any question?
No, sir. No, sir.
No, sir.
Is it clear? Is it clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
So then tell me the difference between sensor and transducers. Anyone tell me the difference between, what is the difference between sensors and transducers?
Excuse me, sir.
So sensor can only read voltages, transducer can read them and convert them to electrical output.
So sensors can attend the particular parameter change.
But say it in a better way. This is our definition. It reads the voltage means what? Okay.
So sensors can sense the physical parameters and cannot change the attitude into the
Yes. In this way that you have to say that we have to approach it in proper way. If you say that, suppose if you ask that what is the definition of sensor? You are saying like that sensor says the voltage and cannot convert to area. This is the answer. Say it properly. Okay. Yes, sensor is the sense the parameters, but not convert to electrical quantity. This is the function of sensors. Right. So what is the function of actuator? What is the function of actuator? What is the function of actuator?
It converts electrical energy to non-electrical energy.
Yes, non-electrical energy means always in terms of some motion, some mechanical motions, right? Means it actuates, it's moving some things, right? So what is the function of that block? What you have said, that is very well conventional element. Anyone? What is the function of that block? That is very well conventional element.
It sends the input quantity.
No. Variable conversion element, what I have said, it converts one variable to another variable. I am giving an example that electrical motor. Okay, what is the function of electric motor? Electric motor converts the electrical to first magnetic, then magnetic energy to mechanical energy. So variable conversion means first it converts one variable to another variable. So that means electrical to first magnetic, right? Suppose in case of Hydraulic actuator, first it converts electrical to some fluid energy, incompressible or compressible fluid energy. Then it will convert to some mechanical energy. Last block, that is energy conversion element. Last energy conversion element, that means mechanical energy. Now it is clear. What is the difference between the variable conversion element and the energy conversion element?
Yes, sir.
Now it is clear.
Yes, sir.
What are the selection criteria? I have gone through so many selections and criteria. The selection criteria, it is clear to you? All the points are clear to you?
Yes, clear, sir. I have a doubt in the classification of transducer.
Okay, tell me. What is your doubt classification? Tell me.
Sir, in active passive, what is the use of strain gauge? Like, how that is a transducer?
Strain gauge is used for the displacement measurements. Strain gauge is used for the pressure measurement mainly. Strain gauge is one type of passive transducers. Okay, it needs some external power supply. Okay, these are passive transducers. And it is used to measure the displacement pressure mainly. Strain gauge. Mainly used for the displacement measurements.
Only for displacement.
Yes. How it is working, don't hide for that. Okay, I will discuss one by one in the next chapter.
Okay, sir.
Okay. This is the introduction. This is the first chapter. Okay, I will mail you the lesson plan. If you go through the lesson plan, this is the first chapter. Introduction to sensors and actuators. So under the sensor and actuators, these are the contents available. First one is the block diagram representation. Okay. Second one is the definition of sensor and transducers. Third one is the what is the definition of actuator, its block diagram. Okay. Through examples. Next one is the classification. Next one is the selection criteria. And next one is the characteristics. Got it?
Yes, sir.
So this is the first chapter covers. First chapter covers. This second, from the second chapter onwards, that we'll be studying that pressure transducer, displacement transducers, electrical transducers, so many transducers, transducers, flow transducers. Okay. Next chapter onwards, we'll be studying.
Fine. Sir, could you please send us the handout?
Yes, I will send you a course handout because already you have joined in the Google Classroom. Okay, you have joined Google Classroom. I will post in the Google Classroom the course handout.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. As well, sir, can you send us the ebooks also? Like, it will be helpful for us to study also.
What?
Can you send us the books, textbooks names or ebooks?
Okay, textbook actually, textbook name actually already I have told you yesterday that textbook is one Patronovich. I don't know if ebook is available to in internet or not. If it is available, you can download it. But if it is not available, ebook, don't go for that. Okay, follow my lectures. Okay, follow my all the slides. I will mail you. I will post all the slides in the Google Classrooms later. Okay, yes, fine. And side by side, when I am giving some lectures, you can side by side put some points also. Suppose I am giving a definition of sensor and transducers. Okay, so you can note down the points what I am saying. Okay. So you can note it down. So if I have any doubts, you can ask me in the next class or in the that class if I have any time. Okay, no issue for that. Or you can, if I, your doubts, you can share in the Google Classroom also. We will discuss in the next class. No problem. Okay, fine. So we will. I will share some notes also. Some notes, but not right now. After covering the three contents, then I will share some notes in the Google Classroom also. Okay, no issue for that. Okay.
Could you just tell the author name again, please?
Patronovich, P. Patronovich. I think it is not available. Ebook is not available. P. Patronovich.
Okay,
I think that ebook is not available. Okay, but not available. If it is not available, don't issue. No issue for that. Okay, no worry. Okay, I will provide the materials. I will provide the slide presentations, everything. This chapter is clear to you? First chapter is clear to you? You have understood?
Yes, sir. Just.
Please respond, all of you. Please, all of you respond. 31 candidates, participants. Please, all of you respond. This chapter is clear to you.
Yes, sir.
So now that I respond your roll call. Okay, roll number one.